Hi there. I am at school right now, and I have one of my school-owned bases. It's a half-size base. And it is January the 5th today, and something that happens this time of year here in the Pittsburgh area is obviously cracks in the wood. Things dry out. Right now, aside from music that is behind me, you might hear, I have my heater blowing around because I don't want to be cold. However, it's hot forced air. And so ebony is notorious for cracking anyway. And so you can see I've got some pretty significant cracks here in my fingerboard on this. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to fix all this and clean it up. And you got them up in here too. So I've taken some of the tape off already. And you can see just how nasty this is. There's just so many, you know, so much dirt and gunk. But the tape doesn't really come off all that well, as you can see. So what I've had to do is just take a razor blade and scrape that off. So that comes off pretty good. Now, I tried in a small spot up here to clean up the board, but I'm going to need to scrape that as well because this is so heavy and thick and gunked up. So I'm going to take this razor blade and doesn't take a lot of pressure, just you're scraping. You're not damaging the fingerboard at all. You're just scraping, and look at all that gunk that's coming up. It's just dirt. I'm not even pulling up any wood, so it's real easy to do. It's all nothing but dirt. Oil, cooties from kids' hands. So I'll finish cleaning that up and then I'll go to the next step. So I got most of this scraped off, pretty much all of it. There might be a little bit of residue and you might be able to see some of that in the camera. So I'm just gonna clean this up. Now, what do you clean up dirt from wood with? Go to your hardware store. Whoop, hold on, there we go. Naphtha. Probably the mildest of petroleum products. You know, things like paint thinner, lacquer thinner, do not use them. Use this. This, as you know, in the guitar industry, we often use this even to clean dirt and grime off of finishes, like lacquered finishes on the body and things like that. So use some of this. Get a bunch on a rag. And I'm just gonna wipe it. And you can see how quickly it evaporates. I mean, it's just flashes off, like in seconds. And don't be afraid to use a lot. I mean, if you like poured this whole bottle in there, it's not certainly something you wanna do, but eventually it's just gonna flash off. It's just, look at that, it's already dry. And you can see how much gunk that pulls up. I'm gonna do the entire fingerboard here. A little bit more on there. If you happen to hear the music in the background, I'm listening to Toto, one of my favorite bands. Next to Van Halen, of course. Okay, so pretty much I've got this cleaned up and looks pretty decent actually. But you can see those cracks and that's the reason why I'm here. Get rid of all of that, in addition to the gunk and the dirt, obviously. So let me tackle that. So the next thing is the cracks, or the cracks. And here are things that I'm going to use in order to fix them. The first thing here I'm going to point out is over there, this is water thin super glue. This stuff wicks into wood and the grain and the pores and things like that. It just goes really deep in there. you can really seal up cracks. I also have here super glue accelerator, and that's essentially what this is. It's not a whole lot different than, you know, any other commercially bought super glue. I get this from Stuart McDonald Guitar Supply, and it's, you know, kind of specially marketed for guitar work and things like that, but, you know, can certainly be used for multiple applications. I always have a bunch of different varieties of their glues on hand. Now, the glue isn't the only thing we're going to put in there. This here happens to be a bag of dust, and you can see it's black. It's ebony dust. It's real wood. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and pack that dust into the crack, and then I will take this little pipette, fill it with the super glue, and then I'll wick that into the crack itself. Once that is done, then I'll take the accelerator and it'll make it dry really quickly. Now, you don't have to use accelerator, you can just let it dry naturally, and it's going to take a few minutes, but this one here just makes it take, you know, seconds. And then I'm going to follow it up with some sanding. I have some 120, 220, and 320 paper here. I'm not sure which one I'll use first, whether it's going to be the 120 or the 220. I prefer the 220, but we'll see how it goes. I also like these things here. These are your ordinary, everyday erasers that you can get at just about anywhere, and they're soft yet firm and dense, flexible. I like them quite a bit, actually, for this type of an application. Not sure how well you can see this. I don't think you can, but take my word for it. These cracks that you see here are filled with ebony dust. And you just kind of pack it in there. You can see where I've got some here, and I'm gonna try to pack it a little bit for you here. I just got this ruler here. I'm literally just spreading that in there, push it down, just kind of working it in. And I'll just keep going along the crack. Okay, so I have my cracks filled with ebony dust, and it's really just difficult to see that. But it is. And I mean, you can see how big that crack is. I mean, just putting super glue in there really isn't going to do much. It'll keep it from spreading, but it's not going to fill anything. At least this thin super glue. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to try to do this as I have camera in my, let's see, we'll start up here. And I have that in my pipette, and I just put a little bead on there and let it soak in. Yeah, it's gonna get a little messy, and it would probably be neater if I didn't have a camera in my other hand. So, I think I need to get a little bit more glue in my pipette. Oh, nope, there it is. Just had to point it down. There you go. Yeah, and that's really all you need. Just get that in the crack. It built up a little bit, leave it there. I really don't care. Okay, so I'm gonna finish doing the rest of this. So here's the cracks, all super glued up. Yeah, I got a couple of drips in there. And doesn't have to be perfect. I'm not a surgeon, I don't have the most steady hands. But it's really okay. I actually went over them twice because it wicked in there so deep that it kind of felt like a crater a little bit. So it really gets in deep. So getting a second coat of the super glue on there should mean that it's sanded flush pretty well. But before I do that, I'm going to do this. This is the accelerator I was talking about. I know it kind of looks like I'm spray paint, huh? But it's not. You'll see it evaporate very quickly. Look how it's dry. What's going to happen is that super glue is going to dry much quicker. And you can see it kind of whitened up a little bit there. That's because I put so much super glue on. But again, it it's going to get scraped and sanded flush. And it's going to be done much quicker than if I didn't. So, yeah, it looks a little bit messy, but sometimes you got to get messy before it looks better. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking my razor blade again, and I'm just going to try to scrape as much of this as possible. And again, I'm not really, like, you know, taking wood off. I mean, there might be a little bit of dust here and there, but essentially, I'm just trying to scrape that glue flush. It's going to take a little while because I have so much. But once you get down pretty close, you can see all this, it's all the glue. You can start, you know, worrying about sanding. And I think I'll probably, after I scrape this, I'll go straight to 220 grit. And see, some of that over spill can come off really easily. It doesn't damage anything. That's about flush. I'm not going to do this whole board for you. I'm just going to do a section of it. Okay, so next I'm going to just get some 220 sandpaper with my little eraser. And now you are going to be taking a little bit of wood off, but again, it's a fine grade paper. It's not really going to be very much. It really didn't take much to do that section. I'm going to take a little 320. And once you get the 320, essentially what you're doing is you're kind of starting a polishing process. Now, I'm not going to take this all the way up to, you know, 400, 500 grit, 600. Whatever it is, I'm just going to go to 320. I think I'm going to hit that a little bit more. I'm going to hit a little more with the 220 first. Seeing a couple of spots. Actually, I think now because I'm using the curvature of my hand there, I think it'll go a little bit better. So I think I'll take that for the moment, and then I'll go back over with the 320. Okay, so next, I'm just going to use an ordinary common lemon oil that you can, just like the naphtha, you can get at any hardware store. And again, for the demonstration here, I'm only doing this one section where the crack is. But I'm going to try to revive this wood a little bit. With a little lemon oil. Just to kind of give it a little bit of luster now. I'm going to rub that in real good. Normally for lemon oil type of an application like this, you want to let it sit for a while, and then you can rub it off. I'm going to just kind of go over it now. And I'm going to show you how that crack is now gone. Can you find it? Okay, if you remember, there's a big long crack all the way through here. And it's gone. Okay, so then I'll do the rest of the board, and I'll show you what it looks like when it's all done. Okay, so here's the finished product. It's got some lemon oil on it. You might be able to see, actually, I can see this little glare here. You see that line? That's actually where the crack is. But for the most part, I mean, that's it.
can't see those other ones up here. This looks good. That's exactly the way it's supposed to look. It's supposed to look. So, now I'll string it up, and it's all good. Can't see the other ones down here either. So, yep, that's it.
Put a little position markers on there. Can you tell there's any cracks in there?
I can't.
Mm-hmm.
It's done.